revolving door between the regulatory agencies of government that have to do with the automobile industry and the industry itself, people going back and forth from one job to the other. Could you talk about that?
Well, there are probably 20 former agency officials from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration at the highest levels, from administrators, deputy administrators, chief counsels, attorneys, and then also engineers at a lower level, who have gone to work for major auto companies and been their advocates on issues dealing with auto safety and fuel economy. And there are rules for the highest level officials not being able to do certain kinds of work for the companies if they had handled certain matters at DOT. But for the engineers, they can pretty much go from one day working at the agency and the next day working for the company. And in the case of Toyota, they hired two talented engineers who have been helping them keep these particular safety problems from being required to be, these vehicles from being recalled by the government.
You also have the situation not only of Toyota that's recalled something like close to 10 million cars now, but Honda with problems with the passenger side airbag recalling up to a million now. How serious is that, Joan?
Well, the Honda problem is also very serious. It's that the airbag comes out with too much force, and that can cause harm. I believe there's been one death, so it hasn't been something that has been as dangerous in just in terms of numbers as the Toyota sudden acceleration. But it's an old vehicle. It's 2001, 2002 vehicles at Honda, and I'm surprised that they didn't recall them sooner. This is now the third portion of that recall. In other words, they recalled a smaller number, then a large number, and now a largest number. I'm happy that they went ahead and did that voluntarily. I think it's the kind of thing that's very hard to identify for the agency, because you have to look at a particular crash and see whether or not, evaluate it to see whether or not the airbag worked properly. But these recalls should be done much more promptly, and the public is at risk if the recalls are not carried out. And the fact that the Toyota still in October, November said that's not a safety-related recall when the sudden acceleration occurs and the accelerator jams to the floor and the brakes can't stop the vehicle is ludicrous.
Joan, we want to thank you for being with us, but I do have a weather question for you. Since you are in Washington, D.C., you're joining us on a telephone, not in a studio. So what's it like in the nation's capital?
Well, the sky is blue, the sun is shining, it's absolutely gorgeous. There is a ton of snow every place. Snow plows have hit the major highways, but not the side roads yet. And even before the snow came yesterday, it was some of the roads were still, major roads, were still very difficult. Like Massachusetts Avenue was had snow clumps and ice clumps all over it, and yet Wisconsin Avenue was great. So it's a very iffy still for people to get around. It's a huge amount of snow. And, of course, if we get 2 inches of snow in Washington, everyone retreats and doesn't like to go out. So for us to deal with 20, 30 inches of snow is horrific.
Well, Joan Claybrook, thanks very much. I think tomorrow we're going to take on the issue of global warming and the intensity of blizzards that we've been experiencing here. Joan is a longtime consumer advocate, former president of Public Citizen. And from 1977 to 1981, she headed the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. Back in a minute. The Drum Thing by John Coltrane. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org. The War and Peace Report. We're broadcasting on over 800 stations on Pacifica NPR, Low Power FM, college and community radio stations, on public access TV and PBS TV stations, and both TV satellite networks, on Dish Network, Channel 9415, Free Speech TV.